Our next guest is known for his entrepreneurship initiative, Go Negosyo. He also runs one of the country's biggest pasta and ice cream manufacturers, RFM, and appliances supplier, Concepcion Industrial. Joey Concepcion, we're so glad he can join us again this morning. Hi, Joey. Good morning. Good to see you.
Hi, Mimi. Yeah, nice to see you again.
All right, long time no see. I want to start with, you're wearing many hats, and we're going to let you wear the different hats this morning. I want to start with your RFM hat. Inflation is everybody's problem. It's proving to be stickier than initially thought. Christmas is just around the corner. Are you expecting smaller Noche Buena baskets this year for Filipinos?
No, the inflation really hit us bad late last year till early this year, no? But since then, commodity prices have come down quite big, no? You have wheat prices have come down a lot, and you've got, of course, oil from its high. It's down, although you have it rising because of this current conflict in Israel. But basically, most sugar has gone down. And so we're prepared for Christmas, no? We don't want to increase prices. Especially ice cream, pasta is a big item for Christmas. So we've hedged out, no? We've hedged our prices, so we're protected. And hopefully, we want to see more consumers spend, no? This coming Christmas, especially. It's a big celebration this last quarter. Mm-hmm. So I'm very bullish that those in the consumer goods will do well.
Mm-hmm. So no more upward adjustments for your prices before Christmas hits?
No, because we started already loading the supermarkets and our distributors with the products. And we want the momentum to really continue and wipe out our entire inventory this coming quarter. You know? So I'm very positive moving even towards next year. You know?
Mm-hmm. Question, Joey. You did say that a lot of your raw materials, the prices have gone down, wheat, sugar, oil, considering the highs it came from.
Milk included.
Can consumers expect lower price adjustments then, or no?
We have already adjusted our prices. And during Christmas, we already start pre-selling and loading the distributors. Mm-hmm. One thing for sure is they're not going to see any price increases. No, mm-hmm. It's a very competitive environment right now, even with ice cream. No? We have a lot of competitors today wanting to grab a market share. So prices of ice cream has really gone down to be able to hold on to our market share. So the consumers will benefit. And we want consumers to spend. And if the products are more affordable, then they can afford to buy more.
How are your margins looking, though, when in this competitive market and you trying to make your products affordable? How are you protecting your margins?
Well, fortunately, from the high of what commodity prices were early this year and to where it is now, the margins are well protected. And that's why we've actually hedged out as far as next year, June. We've secured our raw materials at the prices that are prevailing. So we're able to hedge so that in case there are any further upticks towards next year, especially with the ongoing conflict, hopefully it doesn't last that long, we should be fine.
So Joey, I'm curious, you said you started loading the supermarkets and groceries with your products in anticipation of holidays. Are the volumes growing as well? Or are the distributors, are the groceries not buying as much?
No, I think everybody's bullish that this Christmas will be pretty good. Huh. Of course, I expect that because Filipinos will always, even remember in the pandemic, Christmas was never sad during the pandemic. Everybody spends a bit during the pandemic.
All right. And Joey, are the same strong bullish patterns, are you seeing them across food and electronics? Because you're also an executive of Concepcion Industrial, which just yesterday, by the way, announced this strategic partnership that makes you guys the exclusive distributor of Ninja Shark products. You must be seeing strong demand to be venturing into new brands.
Well, I don't run Concepcion Industries. I sit as a board, as a family member. They're doing pretty okay. There are some headwinds that they face. As more people, more Filipinos become wealthier and can afford, then they upgrade. No? They buy air conditions, they buy refrigerators. So it all spells down to how robust our economy will be and how it will continue to be that way. So, and I always go back to really making our country more inclusive so that more Filipinos can be wealthier now.
And Joey, speaking of more inclusive, I want to shift your hat now. There's a photo, I think this happened just recently, for the signing of women representation in ASEAN. Of course, we know you're the Philippine Business Advisory Council chairman. What does this mean? I think we're flashing the photo now. What does this mean? Why is this groundbreaking? And more importantly, what will be the concrete manifestations or benefits we're going to see from this?
Well, I'm basically putting two of the largest women organizations to work together, Philwen and Women Biz. And both organizations will represent the women in the ASEAN. No? So they have their own women cluster in the ASEAN. And we want a strong representation. As well as that, we will also be asking others, other women organizations who want to join this cause. Of we have this platform of prosperity for all, no? And we all know that the bulk of our micro and small entrepreneurs are women. So it's very important that we, and I've seen it, we have continued over the last 18, we're already 18 years in Konigoshi today, been mentoring so many entrepreneurs, and most of them are women. So by bringing about a consolidation or a grouping of all women organizations, especially in the far-flung areas, no, where they don't have any access to mentors or people that can guide them through, these women organizations out there need also help. So hopefully a coalition of women organizations coming together to helping alleviate the lives of our women, whether they're entrepreneurs or workers in their workplace, is very important. And that is the reason why we've signed, and Ambassador Dele Albert is has been an advisor to us in this area. And she knows that this is the right way forward now.
Joey, shifting to your Go Negosyo hat, you said you guys are turning 18 years this year. Imagine 18 years. Do you still keep count? How many you've actually mentored, and have you set new goalposts for the next 10 years?
Well, you know, from where we were when we started on our first year, that was the time of President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo when she made me her advisor. This whole program has accelerated tremendously. And this would not have been where we are today without all the mentors who have supported us, and of course our sponsors who continue to support the programs. Everybody knows that alleviating poverty is really reaching to those who are in need of it, no? And if you know, sari-sari stores are basically dominated and owned by women. So these are the people in the economic structure, but they are at the bottom of the pyramid. For the economy or even our stock market to boom, is we have to create wealth, not just wealth for ourselves who are already there, but wealth for those who have none. And that to me is the key in creating a successful Philippine economy. And that's why the private sector knows the real problem is how do we alleviate poverty. In the end, we all gain from that. When these people look at the OFWs, why can they spend? Because they make more money working overseas. So how do we do that here? We have to upskill our people so that they will have better pay with companies. Now, those who are entrepreneurs, we have to help them grow their business from a micro to a small and eventually a medium. So this whole effort is really focused on those at the bottom of the pyramid. And this country would definitely continue to grow. More consumers will be able to spend more when they have more.
Everybody wins. On that note, Joey, thank you so much for joining us and for sharing your story this morning.
Thank you, Mimi.
All right.